Welcome to the class of technical textile. The topic which we are going to discuss today is textile in automobiles. Textile in automobiles. So let's start with the introduction. So we'll see what is the potential of textile we use in automobiles, what are the various applications are there, and each and every application then we'll discuss in detail one by one. With respect to the type of material used and what is the use of particular application of textile in automobiles, that we'll discuss for today's class. So if we will talk about the automobile textiles and technical textile, together it is called as the mobile tech. So we have seen the 12 categories of technical textile. So this is a category, one of the category of technical textile, that is called as the mobile tech. Okay, so first of all, what is a technical textile? That already we have discussed in first unit. That is a material which we are using for the technical application rather than the aesthetic. So if we'll use that textile for the various functions in automobiles, that is called as the mobile tech. Okay, it may be a automotive or it may be any transport section. So mobile tech today covers not only isolation and safety aspects, but also with respect to the increase in the comfort and style of people, the automobile sector is increasing, and with increasing that sector, the demands of comfort, especially for the high cost cars, it is day by day it is increasing. So especially in order to get a great comfort, so most of the application of textile we are using for giving this comfort, either maybe from thermal, either maybe from the reduction of sound, or it may be for giving the cushioning, likewise many other applications. And according to this definition of technical textile just to your discuss, so what are these functions are there for each and every category we'll see. So automobile is the lifeline of the present society, many people are using, and global consumption of textile using automobile industry is estimated around 4.5 lakhs tons. Okay, that only for the automobile industry, the use of textile. So textile in transportation are classified as technical because of the very high performance that is going to be provided by the textile products. So examples like seat covering are not easy to remove for cleaning, and it is going to be fixed permanently. So we have to take care of its self-cleaning and easy to wash, because hardly once in a month maximum the people are or once in a year the people are cleaning the car from out to in. Okay, so that type of functional we have to provide. Okay, and also this is going to be exposed to sunlight and it has to be remain for long time. So this is how the what are the function we need, the textile which are going to use in automobile should be of very high performance. This is one example what we have discussed about the seat covering. In addition, they also have to withstand the a lot of higher environmental conditions. It may be a daylight, it may be a damaging due to the ultraviolet radiation that coming out of the glass. Okay, and it must have the stringent safety requirement of flame retardancy. So in the automobile sector, the whatever the products we are going to use, it should not propagate a flame at all as per the standards. So that requirement also need to be met. So this so most of the application we have to give this many functions. So flame retardancy is a compulsory out of that. So it is projected that nearly 45 square meter of textile we are using in a car. Either it may be for interior, or it may be a carpet, or it may be for the side panel. So 45 square meter generally we are using on an average. So this much amount of textile we are using. According to survey, the percentage of textile in motor car amount to 2% of overall weight. Okay, so the textile itself is very bulky substance. So 2 kg itself, we'll talk about the bulk. It may be more, maybe you can say 30% of total car. But weight wise, it is a 2% of total car. It is contributing. Apart these visible textile component, there are the various hidden elements also there. The visible component means seat cover, the carpet, the side panel, that we can see. But there are the various components are there, like inside the engines, the hose pipes are there, the filters are there. So that also a part of technical textile, and that is contributing around 10 to 11 kg of total vehicle. Okay, 10 to 11 kg. So industrial textile are largely utilized in vehicle system, including car, buses, trains, aircraft, and marine vehicles. So at all these, almost all transport vehicles, we are contributing day by day much and much the use of textile for the various applications. So you can see this is the one of the example of car is given. Where you can see the various applications. So if you see this, all the blue colors are the applications are given there. So start with the very essential item, that is the seat belt. Okay. Here the seat belt will be there, and then after that, so it will come to the bottom, the carpet assembly will be there. Okay. All bottom side here, the carpet will be there, and wheel cover, decorative wheel cover. This is not, this is a secondary, but still it will, it is there, textile use, seat cover, then anti-vibration pad will be there, here, and maybe some insulation, textile also we are using there for sound insulation, car foot pedal, and headliners, okay, for provide the sunlight interference. So headliner we are having over here, okay, here. Then the safety belt, and then rack assembly, coat and rack assembly at the back side, the dashboard, okay, the dashboard also maybe it is contributing, the trunk front decoration, trunk crest, okay, and trunk carpet and various other thing in trunk, okay, trunk interior fabric or like maybe a backside wheel cover. Okay, so these are the says some application shown here. We'll see some more application in next slide. So you can see this diagram. So total 30 applications are given of textile to use in the car. Okay, so starting with the first, the sunroof, and the headliners, the convertible tape, sun visor, these are all protection for thermal protection or sunrise protection. Then inside the filter may be there, number 6 means here it is shown. And this first 4 here, this part which is shown here, where the sun exposure is there. Okay. And the column padding, these are the internal components, filter, transmission tunnel. Okay. And here it is shown, this products. Now we can go this bottom side. So we may have the the 18 number the tire cord, then 26 number the again the filters are there, then 28 the carpets are there, carpet backings are there, window frames are there, and what is the backside for back tunnel already we have seen. Likewise, various applications are there where we are using these textile product for the various applications. Okay, now so we'll discuss that all the application one by one. Here just examples are shown. So if you see application wise, out of all available company product, the carpet itself is contributing 33%. The then upholstery, the cover seat, the seat covers, other thing it will contributing 18%, then interior component 14%, and in tire 12% in terms of weight. Okay, the tire cord, the textile nylon filament or the cord which we are using inside the tire, it is a very having some weight, so therefore it is said it's 12%, and seat belts are also very heavy, 8%, 3.7%, and other component 9.7%. So this is a contribution of textiles in a modern cars. So now we'll see what types of fiber we are using for the which type of application. So if you remember this thing, whenever we discuss the application one by one, we can write the given material or suggestion. We can say that this is a summarize of the technical points which we are going to discuss, because the main focus is our on textile, and out of that we'll see here what types of fibers we are going to use for the various applications. So seat belt, as it is exposed into sunlight, we need some good fiber which should absorb the sudden shock also. So polyester is one of the fiber, and as well as nylon also we are using. Then airbags and headliners. So for airbags, compulsory we are using the nylon, where there is a lot of shock is there. And for body cloth, the polyester, nylon, and various other textile product you can use. Then carpet, we can use the nylon. So most of the carpet we will see in market, either it is made of a wool or it is made of the nylon. Then the package tray, we can use the polypropylene and nylon. The door trim, we can use again polypropylene, nylon, polyester. Then trunk liner, the polyester blend. Then trunk cover, PVC coated, nylon or polyester. And for tire, various fibers are available. Out of that, but most we are using the nylon. Okay, the based on the types of automobile, the fiber will vary. If you are having higher heavier use, you may go with the aramid or glass also. Okay, so these are the fibers we are using. So we can see that mainly polyester, nylon, polypropylene, these are the major fiber which we are using in the automobile textiles. Now we can see the application area and what is the prerequisite of automobile textile. In order to use or in order to for have the fabric to use for particular application, what the performance we need from that. So the first it is said that it's upholstery. Okay, so for upholstery we are using, the performance prerequisite for the product is the abrasion and UV resistance, and as well as the design and texture. Okay, so upholstery means here the application we want the that is exposing to the outside. So for aesthetic purpose, we should have the design and texture, as well as it is exposing to the sunlight, so we need the UV resistance, and a lot of wear tear will be there, so abrasion resistance. This is also, we can say, this is a summarize of the total lecture which we are going to discuss. So remember this point, sir. Again, for each and every application we are going to discuss. Then tire cord we need tensile strength, adhesion to rubber, and more important is the fatigue resistance. So more suitable fiber for that is a nylon, and other fiber also we can use. Then coming to the composite, okay, so composite means fiber reinforced composite we can use to make the different component. So from that the main thing is that it should absorb the high energy amount with, and also it should give sufficient strength. Okay, and the carbon reinforced composite is mainly we are using nowadays, that is very famous. And other fiber composite also we may use, even the jute fiber composite also people are using nowadays. And now for rubber reinforcement, like hose and belt and air, where the hose pipe is where the liquid is flowing, there we need a heat resistance. Okay, and then chemical resistance, and with some sufficient strength. So high tenacity polyester or aramid we can use in hose pipes or rubber reinforcement applications. Then for seat belt, it is exposing to, as this portion is exposing to the sunlight, so UV resistance is compulsory, abrasion resistance is compulsory, and strength also it should have. And for that polyester we can use, as well as nylon we can use. Then for airbag applications, only nylon we are using, as I told earlier also. So lot of requirements are there. Okay, it should absorb the shock, and within the less time it should inflate, and it should be durable and it should be stable. Then for carpet, we are using nylon mostly. Polyester is also another option. And what is the trick? It should be light fastness and it should be moldable. So in bottom of a car, lot of different parts are there. So according to part, it should be more. Okay. So this is the total summary of lecture. So you remember this. The same thing we are going to discuss now in detail for each and every application. And these are the, all the points are common for the. These are the, all the point. Again, we are going to discuss with respect to each application. And this is the main part where our focus is there, as we are discussing the subject technical textile. Okay, so do remember this table properly. Now we will see the this broad classification of automobile textiles. So this automotive textile, the broadly it can be classified into the visible component and the concealed components. Okay, so this is the component, visible component means that is the outside and that is the visible, like seat cover, the headliners, the carpet, so these are the application which will come under the visible component. And there are the various hidden components are there that is not visible in the car. It may be a airbag or hose pipes, filter. So these are the application will come under this concealed component. Okay, so visible component include the seat upholstery, carpet, seat belt, headliners, and the concealed component include the noise, vibration, and harness components, tire cord, liner, and various other applications. Okay, so these are the two broad classification of our automotive textile. One is a visible component, another is a concealed components. Now these are the application area. These we'll discuss that one by one. Okay, already we have seen in figure also. Okay, so this is the car body cover, seat cover, the car nylon cord, seat belt, airbags, interior carpets, interior design headliners, and all other applications. So now all these applications we'll see one by one. Most of the application we'll see one by one. So let's start with the application of the car body cover. Very simple application, okay. So starting from outside the car body cover. So as all of you know, this we are using this. To protect the car, okay. So, in order to protect from the, it may be from rain, it may be from sunlight. So, first thing we have to cut it according to the shape of the car, and the car body cover. It is 100% technical textile product. Okay, so not for aesthetic purpose we are using. Okay, just only for functional purpose we are using. So what are the function we need for that? So for sunlight or radiation, we have its ability for protection. So it should have low emissivity. So you might have seen most of the this product is a gray color, okay, or it may be like aluminium color. So that property we are trying to add that because as aluminium foil is having very low emissivity. For that, we have to coat it with like high-density polyethylene and PVC. So this coated material will provide protection with water. The water should not enter, and as well as the light protection. And And mainly this product you may use with the core nylon inside fabric, that is covered with PVC or ideally fluoroethylene. So coating is very compulsory in order to have the waterproofness. So this is the first product. Then we may have the these seat cover fabric. Okay, we can see the back side there. The seat covers. There are the n number of varieties are there. So all we have seen at various places. So the when seat cover, the seat cover, it may be oven, it may be linkage, it may be inside metal, maybe made of non-oven. So there are the various varieties are there. You might have seen the leather seat cover also. Nowadays the 3D oven seat cover also, that is having a lot of advantages. So seat cover is one of the important area of automotive textile, and with the gradually improvement in the manufacturing techniques and with the customer emphasis also on through the luxuries and comfort, the lot of varieties have come into the market with lot of improvement. Seat cover mainly made up of nylon, vinyl, velvet or leather. Okay, we cannot restrict this application. There are the various fabric we can use. So simple seat cover is made up of cotton, and if you go with luxuries, you may find leather or velvet. Okay, and nowadays even you will find a 3D spacer fabric, 3D knitted spacer fabric, that is giving the good cushioning as well and good comfort. The fabric used for manufacturing of seat cover is oven for loom. If you are going for oven, maybe of loom. And as I told, nowadays the knitted lot of knitted varieties also came. And for inside cushioning, the backing we can use the non-oven materials. So nowadays even we are having a lot of development in warp knitting. In warp knitting, lot of good design can be made, and that product also can be used for the seat covers. So the seat cover fabric, that is made up of various varieties, as I told. The further may be laminated to provide a desired protection. If you want further more protection, we may laminate it. But you have to take care of the comfort of the comfort from the product. The fabric further finished also as per the desired specification of automobile original equipment manufacturer. We can use any finish, but we should issue as per the requirement of the OEM. Okay, that is standard we have to meet. Then the another important component is the interior carpet. Okay, so backside of backside you can see the interior carpets. So if it's so you can see in this figure, if seats are not there, there are a lot of types of carpet you can see. Okay, with the various component. So all passenger cars have fitted with this carpet. Okay, all cars should have this carpet. The carpet are laid in cabin, and the carpet are primarily made up of non-oven textile. And that too the needle punch non-oven textiles. The usage of carpet varies based on the interior design. And as we have seen in the last table, what requirement we want, first thing it should be flexible and it should be moldable. So there's no doubt if you use a non-oven, it's can easily moldable. And further, for this interior carpet, we are going with the needle punch non-oven. That is having good cushioning effect as well, and as well as it should have the property, the whatever the soil is there, it should be absorbed by that carpet. Okay, the soil, and as well as it should do the insulation from the heat generated from the roadside or whatever the outside environment, and as well as from the heat insulation. So these are the properties we need. So the product which we are using here, mainly the made up of the non-oven needle punch. You can see this slide in this slider. So this carpet is an important part of automotive textile, and it is made up of the needle felt carpet, or sometimes we may go with the pile carpet also. Okay, it may absorb the more soil or the moisture, as well as the from the personal food, person's foods. If soil is there, that
the next application is the interior carpet. So in interior carpet, like last class we are just seeing the just overview of interior carpet. Now further, this carpet is having the different desirable property, essential properties. Okay. Essential property means it should give the cushioning effect and it should give some insulation. But other than these, carpet should be highly durable, and it should have the high abrasion resistance, and it should have sufficient tensile strength. So generally it is said that the warp should be around 15 kg force. That should be the strength of warp should be there, and wave should be of 45 kg force. And as I told, for flammability, it should must meet that requirement. It should be low in flammability, and it should be good the compression recovery in order to give the cushioning effect. And this fabric should be around this whatever fabric is there, it should be around 500 GSM. So that is the requirement is there. And the carpets are manufactured either by tufting or needle felting. So nowadays we are having this needle punching process for non-woven making. And for felting process means in that is a conventional process where we are using this like similar to needle punching, especially for especially for the woolen fiber that we would have used, but nowadays we are not using that or we are using to limited extent. The needle punching we are mostly using. That is the one way of making the carpet. Then this carpet, it is having this carpet backing. Okay, over the carpet we are having the carpet backing. So that backing should be of spun bonded, okay, spun bonded type of non-oven, that is made from the polymer chips by melting and extrusion. That is having some more pore size. And main polymer used in making this carpet backing is the nylon and polyester only. But during the recent time, even the polypropylene is also trying in order to have a good sustainability and for its recyclability property of polypropylene. The superior needle punch material has a good feeling, which is determined by the amount of vertical oriented fiber at the given stitch density. So if you want a good property with this carpet, so nowadays this the fiber we are orienting in such a way that most of the fiber should come in Z direction. So if the sheet of fiber is there, X and Y direction fiber will be there. Now doing the needle punching, the fiber will come to the vertical side also, like this while punching. Already the fiber will be arranging in X and Y direction. Vertical direction also we are taking, or we are using some lapping process in order to have the pack the fiber in vertical direction. So from that we can get some superior quality, good cushioning effect. So that also we are trying for the manufacturing of the carpet. Then next application is the interior design. So whenever the term design is come, so there is no limit. Okay, so there's a lot of designs are there with respect to the different countries. Okay, we are not having limit to use the color texture and overall appearance. That is not the our focusing area. But other than these, if we're talking about these, the material use, so textile designers nowadays using various innovative interior appearance, okay, and according to the material. So the flat woven fabric, generally the flat woven fabric is itself is only accounting half of the card sheet fabric in Europe, like means woven fabric. But nowadays in this velvet fabric, or we can say that the velvet fabric, that also coming to use in USA. And as I told earlier, the knitting also, especially the warp knitting, a lot of good design we can make, that also mostly we'll find in the Japanese product that they use. And also the circular knitting also day by day, it is their production in interior design is increasing, okay. And especially if you use a card, then you can have a lot of good designs for making the interior for good appearance, okay. So this is the interior design introduction. Now the next application is the this is the hidden application, okay. So the tire cord. Okay, so whatever the kind car, the tires are there, we are having the tire cord. As we discussed in the conveyor belt, like we are having one fabric in between the rubber layers or reinforced with rubber. So this is also the application where similar to the conveyor belt. Here also we are using a tire cord that we are keeping in between the rubber layers. So backside you can see the images of this tire cord. Okay, so it's like mainly it's like the nylon fiber, the bunch of multi-filament nylon fiber. Then either we can use a different construction, like same as we discussed in conveyor belt, the warp-way construction or warp-dominated construction with a very light weight. Okay, just to bind the fiber. Okay, so the nylon cord, the nylon cord we are using in order to get the good fatigue resistance and good tenacity. And so there are the types of nylon, you know that nylon 6 and nylon 6. So both of these are having the good application. So the nylon 6 and nylon 6 is differ slightly and are controlled by the manufacture process and based on the type of stabilizer used and whatever the additives are used. Nylon cord fabric provides the strength to the tire. Okay, the tire industry consumes nearly 98% product, only the nylon is used. Okay, nowadays the advanced fabric also like Kevlar is also people are using whenever the high performance is required, like the tire for the aeroplanes, tire for the heavy duty vehicles, that can be used. So the nylon cord fabric gradually replaced the usage of the rayon and polyester cord in tire industry. So initially, the rayon is introduced. That time the people have used the rayon. Okay, then whenever the polyester is used, the people have used the polyester. But afterward, people have found again that there is a good application of nylon only. Then again, the people are coming to use the nylon only, and most of the application of tire cord, you will see the nylon only as the application or nylon only the product which we are going for the tire cord. So for nylon, if you use a nylon 6, it's having the application in tire because of its high strength it will give, the fatigue resistance it will give, good impact resistance it give, and as well as adhesion with rubber. Should be totally bind with rubber. Okay, we are using this layer in between the rubbers. And these tire cord are generally available with the fabric characteristics of 930 Decitex to 2100 Decitex. Based on the application, this is the mini range of the fiber finders we can use. The critical specification drive the characteristics such as breaking strength, elongation, adhesion, ply tools, and hot air shrinking that we have to take care during the while manufacturing. Then in tire cord, what happens generally, we're talking about the weaving of tire cord. So we are not going with the normal weaving process, like where we have to prepare the beam or other thing. Generally what we are having, from cone itself, we are making a cone of this nylon, and like number of cones will be there based on how many the ends we want to use in cord. So from this cone itself, the thread or the warp thread is coming onto the loop. Okay, so there is no special beam is required. So from this itself, cone itself, the warp will come and we'll insert the weft horizontally, and we'll get a tire cord fabric over there. But main thing is that while manufacturing, we have to keep the standard RH and temperature. Okay, because as we told that the breaking shrinkage or hot air shrinkage, the twist, everything should be controlled. Okay, so this condition we have to keep properly, and directly we are weaving the fabric, and that we are using. And further, if you see the construction of tire, in tire there will be a different layers are there. Okay, it is called and different number of ply we are using. Whatever the tire cord we are using in the form of a ply. It may be a 2-ply, 3-ply. So one layer of our cord will be there, and over that there will be a layer of sandwich layer of, it will be sandwich between the rubber layer. Then again we can use one more layer of fabric, then another layer of rubber we can use. So likewise number of layers can be used, and after that at the top side we are having the tire tread. Okay, so different marks it is having, and so this tire cord, whatever these the cord we are keeping, based on its direction of yarn, we are having the different types of yarn. Suppose this is the cord where all the warps are horizontal in one ply. This is the second cord. This is the second cord application where this we are cutting in such a way that fabric we are keeping in such a way that it is inclining to some angle. Okay, so if you are keeping like this in some angle, that is called the cord cross ply tire. Okay, this is a cross ply layer. Okay, and or it may be a bias or unbiased tire. Okay, and this is a straight way we are keeping. Okay, so this is another types of tire. Okay, uniaxial or biaxial. So this is a uniaxial, this is a biaxial tire. So each one is having its own advantages. Okay, so likewise this cord we are keeping, this the cord we are keeping, and according to direction we are having the different advantage in the tire. Now we'll see the another application. The another important application is the seat belt. Okay, so nowadays it's compulsory to have the seat belt. So seat belt is a function, as all of us know, okay, to absorb the shock whenever accident is there. So the safety harness which secure the passenger in vehicle against the harmful moment during the collision or any other similar condition. So it is used for safety applications. So the seat belt are generally made up of the woven narrow fabric. Okay, we are having the special weaving, that is called as a narrow weaving. And because the width is very low, so very for smaller width, with the smaller, instead of shuttle, maybe we are having the needles. So needle will move one side and will come back like rapier. So we are having this narrow weaving, and we'll use a nylon filament or high tensile polyester filament. Okay, and load specification is important criteria for usage. How much load it is going to be carried, at what load it is going to be break, that we have to check while testing. And how much modulus of fiber, that is also important. modulus is very low, then this belt may can elongate long distance. So we want high modulus fiber. Okay, so therefore here it is said the high tensile polyester filament we should use. And other than this, this belt is continuously it is going to be exposed with sunlight. So UV resistance it should have. And talking about its manufacturing, this belt, the view we are using is the either the twill view or warp rib view, because we want more stretching tensile direction. So if we'll use the twill view, like diagonal running the threads, then we can get a good stretching tensile direction. Or we can use the warp rib view in order to have the good stretching the tensile direction. So the seat belt which we are using car are called a three pointer, which has a single continuous wedding. Okay, and this we can classify the seat belt are classified as static belt or emergency locking retractor belts. Then further, if we talk about these seal belt wedding, seal belt wedding. So the seat belt are made from the nylon filament, as we discussed this. The denier also we have discussed. The typical seat belt. So if you talk about the ends and the peaks, so there are the 32 ends are there in typical seat belts. Okay, which is made up of the medium range of the filament, medium fineness of the polyester filament 1100, so around 32 ends will be there. The major weft yarn prepared from polyester, which is somewhat more fine, 550 Dacitex. And if you are talking about the characteristics of seat belt, then the normal what we want, average and resistance light, capable of removed easily. And it should the load, it should bear the load around the 1500 kgs. Okay, you remember this term. 1500 kgs the seat belt should bear the load. So that much strength of belt we have to make. Okay. Then the seat belt are it should be flexible also in order to give the comfort while driving to the wearer. And it should be rigid as possible in width direction. Okay, rigid in the width direction means whatever the belt is there, this belt should not width direction, it should not collapse. So whatever its shape is there, it should be maintained. Okay, so and it can be easily slide through the buckle. Okay, smoothly it should handle. Therefore, and also whatever the edges are there, this edges should be scuff. Okay, it should not be sharp, or it should not give unpleasant marking onto the skin, and it should be UV resistance. Okay, resistance to UV regard, because from the glasses of cars, continuous skin is exposing to the sun. So nowadays the belts we are making on needle loom, as I told, with a speed of 1000 peaks per minute, so that much speed is available. And with the weft, 200 weft insertion from small weft supplier also you can see. And as I told initially, the view 2x2 twill view that we can use here. And preferably the twill view we are preferring because we want a warp thread like parallel to the face. Okay, and because and from that only we can get a high warp face strength and low elongation. Okay, so this view is also of important here. So this is about the material what we can use in seat belt application. Now next important application is the airbags. Okay, so what is airbags? So airbags that is, it is a hidden application which you cannot see it. So the airbag is an elastic bag. Okay, it is which will provide a cushion and which will inflate or deflect quickly in some stages in certain whenever the car accident is there. Okay, it should inflate, it should deflect quickly. So in it is a safety device aimed for the preventing or minimizing the injuries to the passenger during the accidents. Okay, the airbags having the efficient to put a stop for severe head, chest injuries, and various other injuries during the accidents. And now if we'll talk about manufacturing here. So the bag located maybe front or rear vehicle, maybe in the steering also. So front airbags, this is located to center of steering, or you may found left side, it may be kept to the dashboard. And then it's the side airbags also, sometime we have looked at the side panels, or it may be a roof mounted, door mounted, or seat mounted. But most famous is the at the dashboard and at the steering. Then you will see its product characteristics. The airbags, how it is manufactured. The yarn may be the primary nylon 6 only we are using, okay? Nylon 6 is only we are using, that is coated with silicone. Okay, so remember the material which you are using for preparing the nylon block is a nylon coated with the silicone. And the coating should be such a way that it should not be permeable at all. Okay, then only it will inflate within a fraction of a second. Okay, therefore we are coating with the silicone, and as well as it should give the good impact resistance, and it should be durable. So for durability we are coating with silicones, and as well as we want flame retardancy, because we are keeping it for very long time. So we can see the nylon 6 is a main raw material. So nylon will make the yarn, from yarn will make the fabric. Nylon fabric will coat with the silicone, then by cutting and sieving will make a airbag. Other than this, this component of airbags, it is having one propellant, okay, and in that there is sodium azide is there, okay. So by means of oxidizer, it will facilitate sodium azide to burn when it is ignited, and this chemical is having ability within a fraction of a second to release a lot of amount of gas, and that gas will inflate the airbag. Then second, we are having the inflator assembly. Okay, the assembly is made up of stainless steel, and that will initiate it or receive from the outside dealer and examine the airbag. As I told, it is made up of the nylon, okay, coated with the silicone, so it inflates. We should avoid any seam defect, and it should be totally permeable. Okay, that characteristic it should have. Then other than this, the final assembly of airbag, you can see the backside some different picture, the various position of this the air sheet kept here. Now talking to the assembly part, this airbag assembly mounted on to the tested inflator assembly. Then other component that it may be having, so other than this inflator and this assembly of airbag, the important things is the collider sensor. Okay, when a collision is there, it should sense that accident or that collision, and that it should send the signal to this inflator assembly where sodium azide is going to be released, and it will inflate with a very quick time, with the very less time, in a fraction of a second it will inflate. Then you can see this picture. So where we can so what happened? The time which is taken for to inflate when a collision is happen is a 15 to 20 milliseconds, not second also, millisecond. Everything should be done. Okay, so one side we are having this sensor that will release this azide gas. That azide gas will be taken by the airbags and will inflate. Okay, so generally it is very small explosive device type thing we are having. dried having the sodium azide. And that sodium azide, within 45 to 15 milliseconds, the air bag should supposed to be full, pop fully. Okay, the response time should be 15 to 20 milliseconds, and 45 to 55 milliseconds it should be totally filled, and 75 to 80 milliseconds the airbag should deflect also. Okay, 80 milliseconds, 0.08 second it should deflect also. That much fast it should be done. The function it should be performed. Okay. And then the next application is the headliners. Okay, whatever you car the head at the top roofing is there. So that roofing, the we may use the non-oven, okay, for insulation purpose as well as decorative purpose. Or if you want some more decoration, that non-oven lining you can coat with some other kneaded product or any other oven product. So car we are earlier fitted with the kneaded and oven fabric with the hard cardboard type of backing. But now that packing compulsory we have changed with the non-oven, and the trend has changed, and with the recently the application of non-oven is increased a lot for the headliners. So from headliners, the top safe whatever the heat is coming, it will absorb that heat radiation as well as noise. That so this non-oven is having further very good application in that regard. So therefore non-oven we are using, and as well as it is very much flexible. According to shape it will flexible and it is easy to use. For mounting over the roof. Then these headliners, the product characteristic is having the it is a compound stuff, and majorly the headliners are made up of the tricot knit fabric. Over the non-oven you can use the knitted fabric. The cloth held fast with the melted polyurethane foam, or foam also you can use sometime for cushioning effect. And the headliner non-oven, if you are using, the GSM should be around 180 to 220 GSM. So around 200 GSM it should be used. Okay, and it should have the other than the thermal insulation, it should have the sound damping properties also. And whatever the manufacturing we are doing, it should be as per the standard. And as it is exposing to outside also, so we may have some aesthetic property also, good texture also we can add over that. Then this raw material which we are using is the polyester or polypropylene staple fiber we can use. And needle loom we are using mainly for manufacturing needle punch non-oven. Then insulating felt is another application. So insulating felt, especially whenever we want high noise absorption from engine side or from top side, very thick non-oven layer of this fabric you can put over the bonnet where the sound is more. Okay. So that because of its porosity and thickness, it will absorb the sound. Okay. So that is insulating felt. And generally it is made up of 100% non-oven fabric, and nowadays people are using recyclable polyester also here. Okay, so and the phenolic resin is generally used to bond these up, and so this is the application of this insulating felt. And so two broad manufacturing process, non-polyurethane and urethane, that can be used. And then if for total assembly we are talking, we are having the opening and blending machine, then needle loom, whatever the lap you form will punch with this loom, then forming and molding machine, putting the panel shape will mold it, and then lamination. Okay, so even thermal bonding interlining also we may use it. Then the next application is the sun visor. Okay, so for in order to have the protection from the coming sunlight rays protection, so driver on the top is having some flap, that flap can be down in order to avoid the sunlight coming inside. So the sun visor, other than the normal property, the main property you should have the resistance to the sunlight and UV light. Okay, and generally it is made up of the non-oven and all that you can cover with fabric knitted or non-knitted or oven with which having having the finish with the UV resistance finishes, sir. And generally two sun visors are there. One is for driver and one is for the passenger. The product characteristics is that the main that only thing other than abrasion, this main thing is the UV resistance. So mainly it is made up of three part. One is a backbone material, that is a polypropylene inside or Kenaf fiber. Or that the screen is there or oven fabric is there, like net shape, or that artificial leather or whatever any decorative thing you want, we can put outside. Okay. So that is the application of sun visor. Then another application is a hose pipe. So this is again heated application. So in car there is a lot of hoses are there. So what is this hose pipe? Hose pipe is a media which transport the liquid or air, whatever present in the car. Okay, and it is mainly designed to convey the fluids. Okay, and generally it is a cylindrical shape, and it is made up of the carbon. That's rubber reinforced fiber housing. So in mainly rubber or plastic, we are reinforcing these yarns either in a spiral way or in straight way. So mainly in spiral way we are putting it, and over that it is coating with the rubber. Okay, so it is having one tube element, means one tube is there that is conveying the liquid or solid or gaseous material, and then reinforcement. So for reinforcement we can use the polyester of polyester fiber, or sometimes we may use the even these steel also, and over that cover in order to have the resistance from outside environment, whether the weather or ocean abrasion or from the cut marks, we are having the outer cover there. And then so these are the product characteristics. So you should have abrasion resistance, corrosion resistance, static energy resistance here, and up to 250 degrees centigrade it should withstand there. Okay, so application for compressed air passing, for high pressure fluid passing it can be used. The raw material is mostly the raw material nylon is used for making this hose pipe. So that is the lecture on the automotive textile. Okay, so where we have discussed the various applications. So still the applications are not limited, there is the n number of applications that this textile is there in automotive. So that is about it today's class.